Welcome to this video on the Advanced Search page in SharePoint 2013. You can conduct precise and detailed searches with an easy-to-use visual interface on the Advanced Search page. There is a companion video on basic search techniques, and we suggest you view it first if you haven't done so yet. To get to the Advanced Search page on Connect NCDOT, conduct a basic search. On the Results page, scroll to the bottom and click Advanced Search. On Inside NCDOT, there's a link to the Advanced Search page at the top of every page. The Advanced Search options are identical on Connect NCDOT and Inside NCDOT, so we'll use Inside NCDOT as our example. Let's review the options to search by words and phrases. Our goal is to find training information on e-signatures. Enter e-signatures training in the Any of These Words field. Click Search. SharePoint will return results that contain the word e-signatures, the word training, or both words. Both words are commonly used at NCDOT, so this is a very broad search likely resulting in many matches. Scroll to the bottom of the page to see over 18,000 matches. Let's go back to the Advanced Search page. Use Ctrl-X to cut the words from the previous field, and use Ctrl-V to paste the words into the All of These Words field. Click Search. This time, SharePoint will return results that contain both words. We'd expect fewer results because the result has to contain both terms, not just one. You'll see about 155 results. On the Advanced Search page, cut and paste the words into the Exact Phrase field. Click Search. SharePoint will return results that are a match for the exact phrase, both words in that specific order. We've narrowed our criteria even more, so there should be fewer results. And indeed, there are only two matches. Now, let's look at the None of These Words option. We'll cut and paste e-signatures training into that field. Click Search. SharePoint will return results that do not contain the word e-signatures or the word training. This is a very broad scope, and we'll see well over 1 million results. While this option is not especially useful by itself, it is very helpful if you use it with other search criteria because it narrows the search scope. For example, if we enter e-signatures in all of these words, we get about 288 results. If we then enter training in none of these words, this narrows the results to those that contain the word e-signatures but don't contain the word training. And the number of results drops from about 288 to about 133. The next option on the Advanced Search page lets you filter search results by result type. The default is All Results, which contains all of these categories, as well as results from lists. Documents includes these Microsoft applications, additional Microsoft applications such as OneNote and Visio, and web pages and PDFs. Word includes file types ending in these extensions. Excel includes files with these extensions. And PowerPoint includes these file types. Here's an example. If we search for e-signatures training, we'll see about 155 results. If we limit the search to presentations, there are only about 30 results. Note that using result type is comparable to using the file type refiners in the left column. You can also use the properties of items and files for search. As before, if we search for e-signatures training, we'll see about 155 results. We happen to know that the author of the information we're seeking is Larry Bowder, So let's limit the search by author. On the results page, we'll see about 12 matches. But note that Larry's name is sometimes presented as Lawrence Debowder. So it may be better to redefine our search for only his last name so we won't miss other documents he authored. Let's go back to the search page and loosen our criteria to author contains Bowder. That turned out to be a good idea since we're now finding about 32 documents rather than 12. Now, let's look at the last modified date property. We know there was an e-signatures training document released in the last 2 weeks, so we'll restrict the search to on or after 2 weeks ago. Using these criteria, we get 6 results. We can combine our criteria to look for documents authored by Larry in the last 2 weeks. Add another property row and define the author as containing Bowder. This narrows the results down to 3. By now, you've probably realized that the author property corresponds to the author refiners in the left column. And the modified date property is somewhat like the modified date slider in the left column. In our final example, we'll use file name. Assume we know there's a file about e-signatures training and its name contains the word let. Close the second row and clear out the last modified date. If we simply search for e-signatures training again, we'll get the same 155 results. But if we enter the restriction of file name contains let, we'll halve the number of results to about 72. If you're familiar with Boolean logic and using advanced search criteria in the search box, here's a quick map of how the advanced search page corresponds to those options. In this video, we've examined the options on the Advanced Search page in SharePoint 2013. You've learned the different ways to search by word or phrase, and how to restrict your search by file type, author, and other properties. If you prefer using the search box rather than a separate Advanced Search page, there's another video on advanced search techniques that gives details and examples using the search box. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log in to Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.